What is your favorite kind of poultry?
I don't know, chicken, I guess.
You're ruining this video already. Turkey!
No, chicken's better, but I'll take turkey, I guess. I am suspicious.
Yes, so you should probably do this Turkish trivia.
No. That's just going to embarrass me in terms of how much geography I don't know. Go on, one question from Turkish trivia, then we dive into the box and find out what the hell's in it.
Okay. Only because this is hilarious. I want you to actually read the question because I want to see how you pronounce that. Number two, question number two.
Why are you giving me that? I could have answered question one.
No, but pronounce the thing in
it. A famous dessert in Turkey called tavak gogsu is made with milk, sugar, cinnamon, and 14-day-old bread, 2 chicken, 3 ostrich eggs, and 4 lentils.
Who thinks up this crap?
I mean, based on milk, sugar, cinnamon, probably old bread. Like, I imagine some kind of bread pudding. Let's see.
But who thinks up?
Where's the answers?
I don't actually know. Maybe they expect you to Google them?
Well, that's lazy. it's actually made with chicken.
Well,
they make a dessert with chicken.
There you
go.
All right.
So open the box. Let's see what turkey has for us. Okay, interesting. We will start with clip. These are from Oka. These are pizza sticks. I can't speak Turkish, but I will ruin it anyway. Nusprig schnackgebäck mit Krauten. As it turns out. Thankfully, I don't think I have any Turkish viewers, so it should be fine. Alright. The 3 Turkish viewers extremely offended. I don't know what this goopy thing is, but I'm very curious. Alright, first things first. Pizza sticks. That look like it's tomato and chili. Well, it is a stick, alright.
Eh?
I mean, it's okay. It is just, it's a stick cracker, basically.
Oh, so it's actually not, like, properly
flavored? It's not
flavored,
fried, it's baked. It is flavored. It's just the combination of flavors really isn't that great. Because I like tomato-flavored kind of corn
crisps
snacks and things
and
like
such,
that.
Yes.
But I don't get much tomato out of that. It just tastes like herbs. But yes, pizza sticks. What's the trivia about those?
Let's see. Thin, crispy dough that resembles a cracker is used as the base. It's topped with... Actually, they're describing pizza. That makes no sense. Basically...
Well, they are pizza sticks.
Pizza-flavored crackers. That's all they get out of it.
Okay, well, there you go. There's... What the hell is that?
Oh, my God.
This is... Oh, Jesus. Severzi ozum sukuk. Great molasses with walnuts? What? I mean, for one, it looks like a freeze-dried turd, which is... It's not appetizing to look at all. Grape molasses with walnuts in it? I need a knife first.
Don't cut yourself.
I'll chop up that cat in a minute.
If you do, at least make sure we get it on camera so that way we can monetize it.
I don't think violence is, like, allowed on YouTube. I just say it's okay, I just say it's a prank, bro, and they'll let it go.
Ooh.
Social experiment, you see.
I didn't realize your name was Sam.
No, we disown him. He is a disgusting human being. Almost as disgusting looking as this thing.
That's a freeze-dried turd.
At least this thing doesn't make YouTube videos and doesn't talk, so there's that. But yeah, not the biggest fan of walnuts, so I'll probably avoid the walnut.
This is gonna be hilarious. Yes. I'm sorry, I'm gonna need a close-up of this.
Look at this thing.
This is
one of the most disgusting looking things I've ever seen.
Alright, we're gonna need the slow chew for this one.
Oh dear. It tastes like rubber. Right? It's like chewing rubber. No. I mean, I'm not a big fan of grapes, but that doesn't even taste like grapes. It just tastes like rubber. There's barely any flavor to it, and the flavor is there is highly unpleasant.
Dear turkey, you taste like rubber.
Turkey, you are not doing well so far. Okay, let's see if you can redeem yourself with Cocoa Fest. That's got pistachios so like in it,
doesn't cocoa
it?
Chocolate
it thing? Is a pistachio-looking chocolate, I think.
Well, pistachio would make sense. Mm-hmm. I mean...
Pistachio chocolate is not unusual.
No, well, especially not in Turkey, it isn't.
I also don't like pistachios, so this is not going well. Let's,
Pistachios, so win.
So it's kind of a sort of cream in the middle. It's not bad, actually. The pistachios kind of add a nice sort of fruit flavor to it. So.
Cocoa Fest, you are the winner.
So far, yeah. It's got pistachio puree and pistachio cream in it, which is probably what gives it the good taste. The chocolate itself is not brilliant quality, but that is quite nice. Not bad. Let's have 9 cat tat.
I'm sorry, a cat attack, you say?
These look like banana wafers.
They are banana wafers.
I'll give Turkey this. They have some interesting flavor combinations. A banana wafer is an interesting idea. I mean, really, that should be quite nice in theory. Looks something like this. In practice, it's a very fake-tasting banana. It has a banana cream in it, but it doesn't really taste like that.
Just really, like, fake?
In my opinion, it tastes a bit fake. Why don't you go...
No.
Coward. It's... Yeah. I'm not world's biggest fan of it, but I'll give him credit for at least trying. Ooh, that looks like it has orange in it.
There is one thing with orange in it, I think.
Lovely. It's a kek. 8 kek, as it turns out. Top the
Dan kek, 8 orange cake.
This looks actually awesome. I wonder if this is the top kek. I guess we'll find out.
Apparently, kek is a popular snack item in Turkey, which I guess means cake. I mean, why would it?
I mean, it's just a really flat, broken up cake, basically. Like, yeah. It hardly survived transit, but it looks like a Jaffa cake of sorts.
They filled their kek with bananas, caramel, dried fruits, dates, raisins, and oranges. Apparently it's supposed to taste like an orange creamsicle.
It's a Jaffa cake.
As a bonus, the cake is molded to look like the number 8, so after you've eaten every yummy morsel, you can be extra impressed by what you just ate.
It is a giant Jaffa cake, and that's actually delicious. Yeah, so they did like 2 sides of it. There's like a chocolate side.
Oh, that's kind of cool.
That's good, too.
Good job, Turkey.
Yeah, well done. You made a giant Jaffa cake. I've eaten the rest of that later. All right. Uh-oh. Oh no, it's sesame. Sazam krokakan. Kroken. Yes, so it's a sesame.
Release the kroken.
It's a sesame cake of some sort. Which, if I recall correctly, that's what halva was too, and that did not go down well. Maybe I just don't like sesame in this, like, because sesame is a really strong taste. Like, making something entirely out of sesame seems like a suicidal idea, but apparently some countries seem to like it.
Yeah, this is kind of like a sesame brittle. So you know how like peanut brittle? This is like a sesame brittle. But
God,
yeah,
it smells horrendous.
It is very much related to halva.
Yeah, I'm gonna hate it.
Eat the sand cake.
No. Stop it. Stop compressing sesame like this. Oh, man. It's disgraceful. I need the rest of the Jaffa cake. Oh. God damn it. Why do people like sesame? It's such a strong, earthy flavor. It's like eating soil. I hate that. That is a terrible thing. No. Stop it, Turkey. Quit it. Israel too. You quit it too, but that might be extra bad.
Moving on.
These are orange too. Turtak. They basically look like those sort of Italian straw things that you are supposed to put in like a milkshake or whatever, but they're orange, and that's not what they are at all.
They're like Jaffa cakes, aren't they?
They're actually this.
Oh.
That looks absolutely not. Ah, okay. I thought that's just chocolate. Okay, I thought that was a straw thing.
So is it cinnamon and an orange? Is that what that's supposed to be then?
I assume so. That does look like cinnamon.
On the front, yeah.
Don't know if they have ingredients in English. They do. Orange jelly and cinnamon. That's an interesting combination. I will give that a shot. So, it's kind of got that sort of Danish chocolate sprinkle on the top.
Those aren't chocolate sprinkles, though.
Let's find out.
They're not made out of chocolate. They're made out of cinnamon.
Hmm. Really, really dry, but the orange is, it's an orange jelly, so it's like a Jaffa cake.
Yeah. So I thought it was like supposed to be kind of like a Jaffa cake.
Yeah, that's actually really nice. I eat those on a regular basis. They're, again, a little bit dry.
This is shaping up to be quite the good box at this rate.
Well, I don't know. I mean, it's been some pretty bad things in here, but...
redeeming itself.
This is the highlight so far. I think I even like it better than that Jaffa cake thing.
Wow.
Mm, that's not bad. All right, we do have a few more. Love, would you like my Nutty Max? This is, that's a Kinder Bueno, basically.
Yeah, that's exactly what it looks like.
Yeah, it's just a bigger one.
Kinder Bueno. Size matters.
I love Kinder Bueno. Oh my god, it's even packaged like one. It's a literal ripoff of a Kinder Bueno. See? The packaging is identical.
Wow.
But I do love Kinder Bueno, so if it's anything like that, then it's impossible to open, apparently. One thing they didn't appear to copy is the little thing that you
smart
pull.
Tab.
Didn't copy that. So you have to kind of tear away at the top of it. It's a bit mashed up. Because obviously it's been in transit, but... I'll give it a shot. Hmm. Decent in kind of interpretation, right? It's a lot drier. The wafers.
That seems to be a theme with
this
box.
Turkey
kind of
dry. Yeah, they don't make moist snacks, it seems, but that's not bad. I wouldn't say it's as good as a Bueno. I'd say it's the wafers a lot thicker.
Mm.
Here is a Toffix, which appears to be a cherry fruit chew of sorts. Looks like that.
The most famous gum in Turkey, apparently.
Really?
Apparently it's supposed to have a bit of a harder texture than our gum here.
Yeah. If in the UK, it tastes like Chewits, basically.
Apparently it's sugar-free and can last for hours with full flavor. And it's dentist-recommended because it can prevent tooth decay and gingivitis.
Really?
Okay.
I'll tell you, it's good for hours. It's not even gum, according to this. It's a chew. You don't...
Yeah, maybe I'm looking at the wrong information because I'm like, what? I don't understand how that would be a thing.
This isn't gum, it's a chew, you know? And it's got a little cherry bit in the middle.
I have no idea.
I don't believe that's sugar-free at all. I mean, cherries do have sugar in them.
Yeah, I think it must be something else that's in the box, and it's just an inaccurate description.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm like, what?
Oh, cool, they've got an orange version of it.
Yeah, those must be chews. Oh, here it is. This right here is what I'm actually reading the description for. My bad. They didn't have a description for the other one.
Stop sucking at your job.
They didn't have a description for the other one.
Uh-huh.
I'm sorry.
Fallon, which is chewing gum.
Yes. That is the dentist. Right, you can have that to round off the box. How about that?
Hmm. Okay. It's an Albini, which looks basically like a Twix. From what I can tell.
It does look a bit like a Twix, doesn't
it? Yeah, it's chocolate, caramel, and biscuit, so it just looks like a big Twix. So, let's give that a try. Just a little bit of that.
Apparently, the company that makes Albini biscuits also makes Godiva chocolates.
Really? You couldn't tell, because it's really bland.
Oh, no!
It is a larger, a bit softer, bland Twix, basically. Mm. Yeah, it doesn't have a little flavor to it, I've got to admit.
I'm sorry that Kat is in the background, like, yowling. She's in heat right now, and there's nothing I can do about it.
Nope, not a damn thing.
I'm
so she's going to be permanently annoying. For some reason, there are marker pens in this box. I'm not going to eat those.
I hope not.
All right, so I love Turkish Delight. But
just not that kind.
Unfortunately, it's got nuts in it. Although, it is a mixture of pistachio, almond, and hazelnut, which are the nuts that I find probably the least offensive to my palate, so... It's also vegan and gluten-free.
Well, there you go.
I do like Turkish Delight and real stuff, too, not just the fake chocolate-covered stuff. But as to how good this is going to be, I don't know. This is obviously a very unusual-looking Turkish Delight. You don't usually have stuff that looks like this. but it is going to be interesting to see how this tastes. It's definitely got the texture of it.
Is it sandcake texture?
You'll notice that they're not, it's not completely covered in sugar like the imported Turkish delight you get.
Yeah.
It's actually, real Turkish delight actually has a different flavor to the stuff that we get. Hmm. So, okay. Again, not world's biggest fan of nuts.
Take one for the team.
Yeah, here we go.
It's like, can we even eat it? What do you think?
It's almost flavorless.
Oh no!
And I think it's because they just didn't flavor it. I think they're relying entirely on the nuts for flavor.
Oh wow.
So basically this is just...
Is it like a nut flavored Turkish delight, I guess, or just like
the actual
gelatin?
The actual delight bit has no flavor of its own.
Yeah, that's almost what I meant, but I mean you haven't gotten into the actual nut.
No, I did.
Oh, did you? Oh, mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. Basically, the only flavor is coconut in it.
And oh, it's well, very that's a mild flavor.
Yeah, it's a very mild flavor, though.
Oh, okay.
So, they've made the delight with coconut. So, it's not a rose water or anything like the usual stuff. So,
yeah, actually, I guess if it's vegan, it couldn't have gelatin in it.
No,
it couldn't. Yeah, so that is completely interesting.
Yeah, so it is a kind of vegan delight, yeah. It's, I don't like it anywhere near as much as the other stuff.
Aww.
It's, you know, it's kind of predictable. I mean, it had nuts in it, so I wasn't going to be a huge fan of it anyway, but...
Biscrem,
yes. There are several flavors of this, one of which appears to be apple. The one that we've got is just
I'm pretty sure we've actually had those, and I can't remember where we had those. Yes.
Well, we haven't been to Turkey, so I'm not sure exactly where.
I don't know, maybe I had them in Romania.
Possibly. They're, again,
I am certain I've had these.
Definitely on the theme of dry, which we get from Turkey.
I know for a fact I've had these.
Okay.
They're good, aren't they?
They're all right. I feel like
it's like the molten chocolate.
I feel like I need to drink a gallon of water to deal with the dryness, but
this Biscrem is pretty legit.
But yeah, it's kind of cream filled. Not bad.
For some reason, I was thinking that you had had these at one point, like maybe when we were in Sweden or
something. I don't know. I probably have some. There's plenty of stuff that's very similar to this. But Jesus, Turkey, you're offering dry snacks, man. My mouth feels like it's gumming up at this point. There's some good stuff in there. Some of it is a bit
dry.
Well, dry and bland, mainly. Some of it is from Satan's ass, like that sesame cake thing.
Halva's never going to grow on you, is it?
No. Sesame's terrible. No. The standout of the box, though, is going to be those. The combination of the orange jelly with the cinnamon is really nice.
Which is kind of strange because you're not the biggest cinnamon person.
I mean, I like it in moderation. And the good thing about this is it is in moderation. It's not overpowering. So definitely that, and the Jaffa cake thing is pretty cool. And the fake Kinder Bueno, which is not quite as good as the real Kinder Bueno, so don't kind of bother with it. But yeah, a bit of a mixed box, but it had some really good standouts in it. So not bad, Turkey. You could be worse. I'll give you that. Stop making this. Why? Like, no.
Fresh sand cake tastes good. I promise.